ladies and gentlemen, Glenn Close.
It's a question every actor gets sooner or later. How do you transform yourself into someone else? Well, think about this. How does Angela Lansbury, who has the reputation for being one of the coolest, kindest women in this business, know how to play all those demoned roles so well? Part she calls her hag roles. Well, I think that maybe it has to do in part with her incredibly fertile imagination, her amazing emotional range, and her deep understanding of human behavior. But I think maybe it's something else as well. I was backstage a lot when she was doing Sweeney Todd. I was doing a show just down the street. And what I saw again and again was a star with deep humility about her talent. I saw how her company became a reflection of her ferocious energy and her generous spirit. Angela embraces and appreciates the work and talent of all the people around her. To me, that's a real star. She once said, acting is really understanding other human beings and trusting humanity. When you have learned this, the audience will get any message you wish to send them. And when you feel that message has been received, it's a heavenly sensation. Heavenly indeed. That is Angela Lansbury. Songbird of London's Hamilton Terrace. Grew up wanting to be an actress just like her mom. When her father died, everything went topsy-turvy. World War II. Families were separating, sending children to the country. My mother wanted desperately to keep us together, she said. We left everything behind, and suddenly, we just weren't there anymore. New York. Angela is 17. She gets a small acting scholarship, gives readings, and works up a nightclub act. Then, she follows her mother to Los Angeles. After a year of back lots and casting calls, she was screen tested for one role and wound up with another.
Oh, Elizabeth, this is our new housemaid. I was explaining her duties to her. She'll be down in a moment.
Very good, sir. I'll see you downstairs.
She's a Tartar, ain't she?
What do you mean by that?
Oh, you know, strict lot. I'm not going to sleep in the same room with her. See the way she looked at me?
An Oscar nomination and a 7-year contract with MGM. She's their character actress for those hard-to-fill parts. The innocent in The Portrait of Dorian Gray, she's sacrificed in Reel One. She could be anyone they needed her to be. But the characters got older before she did. Soon it was all heavies and harpies and dour-faced mothers. None more convincing than Mrs. Eisland in The Manchurian Candidate.
You are to shoot the presidential nominee through the head. Then Johnny will really hit those microphones and those cameras with blood all over him. Fighting off anyone who tries to help him. Defending America, even if it means his own death. Rallying a nation of television viewers into hysteria to sweep us up into the White House with powers that will make martial law seem like anarchy.
Despite 2 more Oscar nominations, she felt trapped. Her talents half used. She heard about a Broadway musical looking for a star. It would mean taking a flying leap without a net. She auditioned, then lived through a year of maybe, but maybe not. When the yes finally came, she seized her part at a full gallop.
I have the feeling that time has halted. I'd like two straws and a chocolate malt, 'cause that's how young I feel. I feel like Peckin' and Bonnie.
Sold out crowds and standing room only. They even named a dish after her at Sardi's. Stardom had finally found her, but Angela had just gotten started. This time, a classic.
Goodbye to blueberry pie. Good riddance to all the socials. I had to go to all the...
No tepid revival. This was history-making on its own.
Attend the tale of Sweeney Todd.
What your rush, what your hurry? You gave me such a fright. I thought she was the ghost. Half a minute, can't you sit? Sit you down, sit. All I meant is that I haven't seen a customer for weeks. Did you come here for a pie, sir? Do forgive me if he has a little vague. What is that? But you think we have a plague? From the way the people keep avoiding, now you don't. Mind you, I can't hardly blame.
She had crossed the divide from star to Broadway legend. For an encore, she takes over American television on Sunday nights, holding the top spot for over a decade.
Chess.
They almost did it. They were that close to getting away with it.
Every week at 10 to 9, we were confident she would figure out who done it. As the country's Sunday night sweetheart, she won her biggest audience yet. No one ever found a part she couldn't play.
You're nimble with a sultry voice.
Bonjour!
Bonjour! Bonjour!
She's one of a kind. A grand and exuberant actress.
Honor Angela with songs from her musicals are three of Broadway's brightest stars. From Kiss Me Kate, three-time Tony nominee Maren Mazie, two-time Tony winner Donna Murphy, and this year's Tony winner from Contact, Karen Ziemba.
It's a time for
a parade in town. Were there drums without me? Was a parade in town? 'Cause I'm dressed at last, at my best, and my banners are high. Tell me, while I was getting ready, did a parade. I'd like two straws and a chocolate malted, cause that's how young I feel. I feel like pecking and bunny hugging and Lindy hopping and chitterbugging, cause that's how young I feel. I'm mad for that Big Band beat. Wanna ride in a rumble seat. Sheldon's got the Chevy, love a face full of frozen custard, to have a hot dog with sand and mustard and ride the Ferris wheel. Oh, honey, cause
lovely, if laughter is no longer lilting, if lovers are no longer loving, then I don't want to know. If summer is no longer carefree, if children are no longer singing, if people are no longer happy, then I don't want to know. Enchanted, my memories burn in my head with a steady glow. So if my friends, if love is dead, I don't want to know.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nathan Lane.
Away from me, you can climb the tallest tree, so go on and try, just try, and you're gonna see how you're gonna not at all get away from.
Wait, watch a rush, watch Harry, you gave me such a fright, I thought you was a ghost, half a minute, can't you sit, sit you down, sit. Seen a customer for weeks. Did you come here for a pie, sir? Do forgive me if my head's a little vain. Ugh, what is that? What, you think we had the plague? From the way the people keep avoiding, no you don't. Heaven knows I try, sir, but there's no one comes in even to inhale. Right you are, sir, would you like a drop of ale? Mind you, I can hardly blame them. These are probably the worst pies in London. Even that's polite. Worst pies in London. If you doubt it, take a bite.
Ugh.
Is that just disgusting? You have to concede it. It's nothing but crusting. Here, drink this. You'll need it. The worst pies in London. Ah, sir, times is odd. Times is odd.
Ladies and gentlemen, Len Carreyrou.
Beautiful, wonderful Angela, incredibly talented. I'm so proud to be here. You coax the blues right out of the horn, man. You charm the husk right off of the corn, man. Whoever thought a Yankee could put our little Dixie bells to shame. You made us feel alive again. You made us have the drive again to make the South revive again. Maine.